Skinnamarinky dinky dinka, skinnamarinky dinky doo a boop, la paddy bop, skibby dibby da bibboo. Okay, sorry about that. Yes, now you know what I do on the menu screen, how I sing to it. But anyway, hey, and what is happening, guys? Yankee here, we're back for some more Let's Play Banjo-Tooie. Right now, we are in front of Jiggy Wiggy's temple, and we are about to open the next world of the game. So, as promised, let's enter the temple and give our old buddy a visit. A visit? A biscuit? What? Aw, oh, man. But anyway, yes, Jiggy Wiggy's temple. We will step on the pad right here. And actually, no, we don't have to step on the pad. We can just go to the puzzle piece now. The puzzle piece area and hit B. And let's take on his test. Alright, so let's see. It's a little hard. The puzzle's a little harder. Oh, God. Why wasn't I good at this as a kid? But no, I was pretty good at puzzles. I don't know. Who plays with puzzles nowadays, though? Banjo-Tooie and Banjo-Kazooie franchise are going retro with their whole puzzle theme, I guess you would say. So let's just do that and do that. There we go. 19 seconds it took me. You have completed Jiggy Wiggy's challenge, too. So now the Great One will show you the way. Yeah, show me the meaning of not feeling lonely. It's just a feeling. Okay, don't sing in sync. Alright, hopefully Jiggy Wiggy will sink us to the next world. Oh, great segue. Behold, the power of the mighty Jiggy Wiggy.
He's got the power.
Oh, God. I don't even know I can go that high. Isle of Hags, plateau, a new area. How are we getting here? And now that's the next world right there. Now that that's been blasted. Oh, okay, delayed explosion much. What the hell, man? That just, like, take time is like, you know what? I'm gonna blow up right now. And you are indeed the chosen one. You also have enough to open the next world. I'm gonna hold off on that. I know I could open up it right now and just kill two birds with one stone, but, we're not up to that world, so I don't want to bring it up now and, you know, have that in the back of my head. But what I want to do is actually, before we move on, I put off this part. I want to just bring it up now because it's actually a pretty interesting area. Let's see, is there actually anything behind here? I doubt it, but might as well check. Oh, okay, question mark sign. What's here? Suitable eggs may be found closer to home than you think. What, because we're staying next to a giant egg, really? Or maybe he was talking about stop and swap, I don't know. Let's enter this area, let's see what we got here. This is Heggy's egg shed. Cluck, hello, cluck, Heggy the hen. Hi, Heggy, I assume something egg-related happens in here? Tell us, Peggy Hill. Cluck, cluck, bear, cluck. Find special egg, cluck. Then Eggy hatch. Alright, I was supposed to say Clucky Hill or whatever, I don't know. But anyway, let's see right here. We have nothing in this area just yet. Basically, the whole gist of this area, it is a stop and swap area. And we can't access that just yet. So we can't really do anything here. I just wanted to bring it up. Throughout the game, we'll be finding stop and swap items such as eggs. And we bring them here to hatch. Heggy will hatch it personally. So there you go, Heggy Hill. So let's see right here. Yeah, let's get past you, you little enemy. Monster schemes. So yeah, I just wanted to show that off now and whatnot. Probably people were asking. So I give the people what they want. And everyone probably knows, like, I know a little bit about stop and swap, so I think I should show that off. I mean, it's only true justice if I do. And let's see. Magic Lobo creatures are usually found near Mumbo Jumbo and Humbo Wumba. Oh, I forgot to mention that. Yeah, basically they're found in the vicinity of those areas. The first world that was kind of easy, but in the later worlds they actually get more spread out. So thanks, Jam Jars, for bringing that to my attention to share with you guys. And we have some notes in the outside of the worlds. That's actually pretty new to this game. Well, it is new to this game. And we have a silo making getting back here much easier. Let's see what else we can do here. I hear a Jinjo, but I believe he's trapped under a rock, as grim as that sounds, so we can't really help him out here. Yeah, I believe he's under there, so sorry, Jinjo, we really can't do anything for you. My bad. And wow, we have way more notes than we need for this one. Fire eggs. Now's the time for you to learn shooting eggs that crackle and burn. Yes, new to this game is we learn different types of eggs, not just the blue ones. These ones are fire. A brand new egg you have acquired. Now I'll tell you how they're fired. Tap RB or LB to get your eggs on. You tap it again until it's right for you. That'll be all. Oh, come on, do it, do it, do it, do it, do it, do it! Yes! 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 Oh, okay, that took, what, seven parts, okay. All right. Oh, I just felt like the N64 kid. I was waving my fist up in the air, like, pumping it. Oh, my God. You have no idea. Like, stupid, like, crap like that in this game. I don't know. I just adore it. I just love it. Every time he misses, it just makes me a little happy inside. Brings out my childlike wonder. But, yes, basically, there's empty. You gotta go behind here, and seems like we're entering a beehive kind of thing here. So, let's head inside to Honey's Bee's Hive. Or Honey Bee's Hive. Really original name right there, I must say, Rare. Hi there, Big Bear. I'm Honey Bee, mistress of the honey. Oh, why couldn't you be mistress of the jiggies instead? Because that would have been it made your quest too easy. However, I can grant you extra energy units in return for empty honeycombs. I suppose that's better than nothing. Don't be so rude, Kazooie. Oh, sorry, wasp lady. I'm Honey Bee, a bee, not a wasp. Right you are, Hornet Girl. Aw, you have enough honeycombs for two more units of energy. Wow, two more, awesome. Do you want to trade? Yeah, sure. Sure, honey. Aw, toss your honeycombs over here then, Big Bear. Whoa. Whoa. That wasn't, phallic. Here's your extra energy. So yeah, we gained two extra lives right here because we had enough to gain two. I think it only takes like, two, then three, and now it's five is the requirement to get the next one. So there we go, awesome. Definitely want to do all these things before you enter the next world. Not saying it's hard, but hey, it helps. We can't do anything over there just yet, so for now, let's actually make with my promise and enter the world. I know it's for 7 minutes in, but hell, it took long enough, right? Just wanted to show off a few more things, but here we are. Glitter Gulch Mine. I don't know why I said glutch. Glutch is not even a word. And, oh, hey, okay, easy, easy, easy. Easy. We have a new thing right here we don't know how to use. These are the springy step shoes, but you'll have to come and find me before you can use them. So that's pretty cool. We actually learned different shoe moves in this game. So that's awesome. And not leaving the world, don't worry. I just want to get to this Cheeto page. And there we go. Okay, good. Oh, hey, five pages. We got it. At last, come and see me in the Grunty's old lair in Spiral Mountain. And I'll tell you your first secret cheat. Alright, so we definitely gotta remember to head back to Cheeto and learn that new move. But for now, what I would recommend doing first, I actually was thinking about a strategy to do this world in. And this actually presented itself as a very valid case to do first. And I have to find that Globo. It's outside. I'm an idiot. At least we got the warp head done with. Let's see. Okay, we got TNT over there. Might be foreboding of what we're about to get. There it is. There's the little Globo, and it doesn't matter if you, say you use this Globo for Mumbo and use the other Globo for Wumba, it really doesn't matter. They're both the same type of Globo, so it doesn't really matter. And yeah, a little side note of this world, this is actually supposed to be in the first game, Glitter Gulch Mine. I believe this was cited by multiple times by Rare, and it was even said in Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts in the Banjo World, I think. When I played the tutorial, there we go. We're gonna give her the Globo. Sure, I'll just throw it in. Yeah, we know the formalities right now, so every time we speak, it's gonna be the same sentences over and over. All right, so how we get jump in here? Let's do a backwards dive swan dive. Okay, I give that a 9. No, 8.5. Who always gave like the bad ratings? The Germans or whatever? I don't know. They always made fun of that in cartoons. Wumbo, call this detonator. Use left stick to move and press X for self-destruct attack. Okay, so now we are TNT. Dynamite. Yeah, that's basically what we are, dynamite. To use it, we have to go to these little fuses and just go up to them and hit X and kaboom! So there we go, we got to pretty much unlock three different things in this world using the TNT little body kind of thing. And if you use it as a normal attack, the explosion, self-destruct kind of thing, it actually hurts you, so use it sparingly. I wouldn't recommend fighting people with it. So basically just do all the TNT-related things and you should be fine. And we just want to go right here, the fuel storage. The reason I didn't go left with Banjo-Kazooie because there's really nothing we could do as them just yet. And this is pretty much why I wanted to tackle the TNT things first, because I think it's just better to get all things out of the way before we start exploring the world as Banjo and Kazooie, so I think it's a lot more convenient that way. And I think the guide actually suggested doing this first, so I actually listened to it, and let's get to this fuse. Okay, basically if you miss the fuse and do a regular attack, that's what it does, but it should lock into place, and... ba-boom, and boom goes the dynamite. You knew I was gonna make that reference in this part. And there we go. Ooh, what the hell? What's in this box? It has a space, planet on it, so it must be an alien. Because anything space-related is aliens, right? Alright, so it's just levitating away without questioning it. Okay, I guess we did good. For all I know, they're bad aliens, but... oh well. Mission accomplished. And in tomorrow's paper, Banjo ruins the world and causes mass genocide across the land. The galaxy is not saved thanks to him. He's the bad Commander Shepard. He went renegade option right there. I just beat that game, by the way. The ending wasn't as... I don't know why a lot of people were complaining about the ending, but that's a whole can of worms. I'm not going to talk about that. But yeah, I chose to control the Reapers into the blue one. I don't know. I thought it was pretty satisfying, but oh well. Actually, one more thing we want to do, I believe. Yeah, there is one more. And that is going down here. Is it? No, it's not. It's actually this way. Okay. No, wait, that's the entrance. Confused. I'm getting confuzzled. Let me think about this. Okay, I got it. It's to the right of Mumbo, as I remember now. And it's funny, because when you're on water, you can actually, you won't sink. You actually just, like, float on it, so that's pretty fun. We're not fun. We're just not dying. How about that? Let's see. Is it down? Let me check. It is. Let me look over my shoulder. I'm not cheating. Don't worry. It is not the water storage. It's actually where the tracks end to the right immediately. Let's see. Right here. Okay, good. There we go. I knew it was over here somewhere. And let's just go down this little tight little passageway. So yeah, have you noticed in this world danger keep out? Nope. Okay. We don't want to hurt ourselves. Self-mutilation is never a good thing. But as you see in this world, there is a lot, like, just like the last world, there's a lot of areas you enter that aren't inside the main world. In this area, I think it overdoes it a little. There's so many things to do in this area, and it's just a little overwhelming. That's why I don't like this area. And in certain missions, I don't like either. So, just don't think I hate every world in this game. Don't get me wrong, every world is great, but this one, just, it's... I don't like it, I don't know. The music's great. Grant Kirkhope, I've not mentioned this in the playthrough before, but he is god. He made all the best tracks in Banjo-Kazooie and Banjo-Tooie games, and this is definitely a great track, but nothing against him. He didn't program the game, obviously, but I just don't like this world a little. I don't know. It's always the second world that I never like, but Treasure Show Cove was alright, but yeah, it's always the case with me. Yeah, let's actually head over here. We freed those alien things, but we couldn't really do anything with them, so maybe if I talk to them, something will happen? Maybe if he'll give me a jiggy or somewhat thing? I don't know. Kind of saved their skins, but maybe we escaped the bad skin, I don't know. This is the fuel depot, by the way. Alright, so hopefully they come in peace, I hope so. Alright, let's find out. And basically, yeah, a lot of enemies are, like, mine-related. And let's see. Bleep, now that door's not open on the other side, bleep. Huh? Can we leave? What's... whoa, okay, you shouldn't have seen that. I just spoiled the next world. Yeah, I thought that door was open. Oh well. So you got a glimpse of what the next world was. I could have unlocked that, actually, with the puzzle thing, but... nope, not yet. Alright, so we can actually make some progress in this world. I feel like we're, like, 14 minutes in and I still haven't done anything. So, let's actually learn the move that we have to learn that's been inhibiting us. Let's actually explore the world, too. Might as well do that. I'm sorry if this isn't, like, typical, like, enter the world part one kind of thing, but... I just wanted to get my, bearings together and, let's see, is this the right way? This isn't. What the hell? Where am I going, man? This is why I don't like this world either. I get lost all the time. Oh, it's to the left. Okay. It's to the left. Or my other left. That's right. Alright, so let's, climb up here and at least learn, one of our more useful moves that we'll be seeing throughout the game. And click some notes while we're at it. And it's pretty hard to keep track of how many cheekies you get in each roll and how many notes you get in each roll, because they total it in this game. So I wish they kind of did a sub thing, but that's why they have you total, so can't complain. Okay, easy, buddy. Easy, Banjo-Kazooie. I know we're in a mine, I know you're gold crazy. I know you can see some gold in them hills, but... Aw, man, I totally forgot. What I was going to do when I entered this world was, where is Jam Jars? Oh, he's on the other side. Crap. Whoopsie doodle. What I was going to say is, the guidebook, each area had, like, this paragraph synopsis of what the world's about. I should just read in, like, a John Lovitz voice just for old time's sakes, but I forgot to do it. Oh, well. Bill Drill, this makes breaking so much fun. Now listen up to how it's done. Leap high in the air and then hold LT and RT and watch Kazooie spin and deal with her head. Really doesn't have the same touch as the N64 explaining, really. LT and RT, that's just hard to explain. But oh well, we've got the Drill Bill attack. Basically, we can make those boulders disappear by doing like a ground pound kind of thing. But let's see, we do like a drill. And there we go, an empty honeycomb for our troubles right there. And let's actually enter this house right here. I was about to enter it, but I wanted to learn the Drill Bill attack, because that's actually related to this little house right here. And, it's a little sad in here. Prospector's hut. Howdy! Who might you be? I am Bill. I'll bet your other name is gold-related. Wait, what is it? Gold Bar Bill? Klondike Bill? Nope! Billion Bill's my name! I thought so. What's up, Bill? My rodent partner, Dilberta, went looking for gold, but she's gone for far too long. We'll keep a lookout for her. Not so fast, Banjo. Make sure he makes it worth our while. Oh, okay, can we have a prize if we find her? You city folk are all alike. I wonder where she could be. Hey, that's the mouse we ran into last time, or the mole. Eek, I'm sure I came through in a tunnel. So we actually saw her. Interesting. Can we save her by entering this area? I don't know, can we? Or is it blocking it? No, it's blocking it. We're going to have to go back to Mayan Temple to, pretty much get that jiggy, so I'll probably save that for last, but just wanted to know that we're gonna get her. We're gonna get her. Let's see, I heard Jinji? Jinjo, I'm sorry. Oh yeah, I know where that Jinjo is. Let's go get him. I think he's in the mine shaft area. Yeah, he is, okay. I hear you, Jinjo. No, Jinjo gets left behind. Saving Private Jinjo just popped into my head, oh god. But yes, I think we'll have to end it here. I'm sorry if this wasn't the most productive part, but we showed off a lot of different things, that we had to do anyway. We got some extra, life bars. We got to meet Heggie, who will be dealing with our stop and swap related things later on in the game. And, let's get that Globo and knock that down. And, yeah, we blew up all the barriers that Banjo-Kazooie can now enter, thanks to Humbawumba's TNT, a little transformation. So, now let's destroy this. So, I think I'll see you guys next time on Let's Play Banjo-Tooie. We'll be talking to Mumbo and seeing what he can do to help us in this world, and hopefully be collecting more jiggies and making more progress in Glitter Gulch Mine. So, I will see you later, guys, and until next time.